रेस्पॉन्ड दिस थिंग, यू आंसर माई क्वेश्चंस। फाइन, चलो हम शुरू करेगा। यस, इन अवर चाइल्डहुड वी यूज्ड टू प्ले विद द मैग्नेट्स, यस आर नो? वी यूज्ड टू प्ले विद द मैग्नेट्स, टेल मी वॉट इज द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, वॉट इज मीन बाय मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, what is meant by magnetic field? Yes, what is meant by electric field? In our course, in our subject, we are going to discuss about the two major concepts. One is electric field, the other one is magnetic field. One is electric field, the other one is magnetic field. Here we are going to discuss about what is meant by electric field. When we have the electric field and what are the different type of causes for this electric field. What is meant by electric field? And when we have this electric field, what are the different type of causes for the electric field? At the same time, what is meant by magnetic field? Magnetic field. When we have the magnetic field and what are the different type of causes for the magnetic field. At the same time, we are also going to discuss about how this electric field will affect the magnetic field. How this electric field will affect the magnetic field in return. How this magnetic field will affect the electric field. Yes, how this electric field will affect the magnetic field and how this magnetic field will affect the electric field. That is the interaction, I can say. Interaction between electric and the magnetic field. The interaction between electric and magnetic fields is called as a electromagnetic fields. Yes, write down, take the statement. Electromagnetic fields, write down, all of you. Electromagnetic fields is a branch of electrical engineering. Electromagnetic fields is a branch of electrical engineering which deals about the interaction or the interplay mechanism between electric and the magnetic fields. Electromagnetic fields is a branch of electrical engineering which deals about interaction or the interplay mechanism between electric and the magnetic fields. Right. Now tell me, what causes this electric field? When we have this electric field, what is the source for the electric fields? What is the source for the electric field? What is the source for the electric field when we have this electric field? Yes, voltage, current. Yes, current, electron. Yes, charges. Exactly. The basic fundamental element we are discussing about the charges. Even we have discussed this thing in the networks also. The charge is a fundamental element which will cause us. Yes, fundamental element. It will cause us. Can cause us. Electric fields can cause us electric fields can cause us magnetic fields can causes magnetic fields. Can also causes electromagnetic fields. Can also causes electromagnetic fields. Charge is a fundamental element. Charge is the fundamental element. It will causes electric fields, magnetic fields, and also electromagnetic fields. Charge is a fundamental element, will causes electric field, will causes magnetic field, will causes and also causes electromagnetic fields also. Now let us see when the charge causes electric fields, when the charge will causes magnetic fields, and when it will causes electromagnetic fields. Right. Now copy this thing now. Now chalo. Now see this thing here. So charge. What the charge is? One particle. Charge is what? One particle. As we know, in general, the particles, how the particles are? Some particles may be a stationary at rest. Some particles may be under motion. Particles may be a stationary. Some particles may be under motion. Let us consider how much charged particle. Consider here how much charged particle. My charge is at rest. How much charged particle? Let us say that the charged particle is at rest. See what's going to happen. Consider I have one positive charge here. This is my positive charge. Let us say this positive charge is at rest. This positive charge is at rest. Consider. Now see what's going to happen. I have taken one point here. If I place one more positive charge here, what happens now? If I place one more charge here, what happens now here? This other charge will experience a certain amount of force. The other charge will experience a certain amount of force. That force may be a attraction, may be a repulsion, that depends upon the polarity of the second charge. Since this is already positive charge now, isn't it? Now see this thing here. If I place the charge here, then we have a force on at this location also. We have force now. If I place the charge here, if I place now here, we have a forces because of the charges are big charge now, isn't it? So what we can say now here, if I place the charge here, yes, now in that case, so we have a charge will be all. Yes, the charge can able to create certain amount of region, isn't it? All that region is under control of the charge. Yes or no? Understood? Yes. So here, at this location, we have some effect of the charge. Here we have some effect now. Here we have some effect now. Here we have some effect or not? And so what we can say now here, how the effect of the charge, it is a one dimensionally, two dimensionally, or three dimensionally. How the effect of the charge, it is a 1D, 2D, or 3D. Tell me. Yes, so now here, let us consider. Dekho here, a mere charge. Let us consider. If I play the charge, one more charge here, we have some effect now. Here, everywhere we have effect or not? Now here, we have effect or not? So how should be 1D, 2D or 3D, tell me. 1D, 2D or 3D, three dimensionally, isn't it? Yes, So we have some effect of the charge will be all around this thing here. So this 3D means I may consider this might be some sphere I can consider like this. Yes or no? Yes. All this region I can say under the control of the charge I can say now here. Now what I am doing is I have taken some random point in this region. Then what happens now here? I have taken some point here. Do we have any effect of the charge at this location, at this point? Yes or no? Yes. The effect of the charge at this location is called as a electric field caused by the charge. Once again, if we have a charge Q here, the charge can able to create some region in it all around it now here. So if I take any random point inside that region, we have some effect. Yes, we have some effect of the charge at this location now here. The effect of the charge at this particular point is called as a electric field caused by the charge at this location. Understood? So this electric field we are denoting with a letter of E. Sir, how dimensions are visualized? I am lagging in those dimension concept. This is my charge now. If I have a one more charge now, we have some force now here. This direction we have force. This direction also we have force now. This direction. If I play the charge above, we have force or not? Yes or no? Prabhakaran. Yes or no? Yes. Now this is what on this. If I play downward, we have force or not? X axis, Y axis, and we should take Z axis now. Three axis. Isn't it? We got three axis. We got now. Let us X axis, Y axis, and Z axis. Isn't it? So we can imagine like a room now, isn't it? At each location we have a effect now, but anything can consolidate into three axis. Yes, exactly. That only now we are doing three axis only we are doing now. That's why we are calling it three dimensionally. Is it Prabhakaran? Yes. So right. So what we can say now, the effect of the charge at this location is called as electric field. Yes. And see this thing, on what factors the electric field will depends. Tell me on what factors this electric field will depends now. Let us say I have taken this point here. We have some effect now. If I take this point, I have taken like this. Now if I change the point now, is the effect of this electric field changes or not? So from this, what I can say now? My effect will depends upon what factors? Distance. Yes or no? So I can say more specifically, my effect of the charge, it will depends upon the space I can say. Yes or no? The effect of the charge will depends upon the space. I can say more specifically, how I should indicate the space parameters. Tell me what the space parameters will indicate now. X coordinate, Y coordinate, and Z coordinate. Yes or no? So this is my effect of the charge, that is nothing but electric field, will depends upon what now? Space now. Space. So I can say it is X, Y, Z. Isn't it? Now see this thing here. Now this effect depends on X, Y, Z. Will the effect of the charge depends upon time or not? Tell me. will the effect of the charge will depends upon time or not? Why not? Why not? Why the effect does not depends upon time? Yes. Why the depends upon time here? How the charge here? If it is more, yes, how the charge is now? How much charge is at rest only now? The charge is always at the same location? Yes sir, no. 8 o'clock same location, 10 o'clock or same location, after 10 days also charge is same location. Is there any variation of electric field with respect to time variations? Since the charge remains constant, the electric field does not change this point or not with respect to time. So what I can say now, my effect of the charge, that is electric field, will depends upon what factors, tell me. My effect of the charge, that is because of this electric field, will depends upon what factors now? Only space and it is independent of time now. Only space and it is independent of time. Yes, since it is independent of time, so that's why I'm calling this nature, I'm calling it as a static electric field. Since it is independent of time, so I'm calling this as what? Static electric field. Right. What is the meaning of static system? In the signals and systems, you might have heard about static system, dynamic system. Isn't it? Static system means what? The system which will not rest. Static means here, if the response of a system depends upon time, we can call that as a dynamic system. If it is independent of time, we can call that as a static system. If the response is depends upon time, we can call dynamic system. In your C language also, you might heard now, static allegation, dynamic allegation. Isn't it? What is the meaning of static allegation? Fixed. Yes, independent of time. Understood what I'm saying? Yes. So this electric field, which we are calling a static electric field. The study of the static electric fields is called as a electrostatics. The study of the static electric fields is called as a electrostatics. Understood all of you? Fine. Yes, Prabhakaran, Amit, koi doubt hai isme? Right. Now. Fine, we'll move to the next topic now here. We'll move to the next one here. Right. So, first case we have taken the charges at rest. Particle is at rest. What is the other possible case, tell me now here? What's the other possible case may happens now here? Charges are what? Moving. Other possible case, charges are moving, isn't it? Charges are moving, yes. Moment of the charges, flow of charges is also different manner. Charges are moving. Some charges may, some particles may be with a uniform motion, some other particles may be under non-uniform motion. So now, some particles may be uniform motion, some other particles may be a non-uniform motion. What is meant by uniform motion? What is meant by uniform motion? If the particles covers equal distance in the equal intervals of time, that type of motion is called as a uniform motion. Equal distance in equal intervals of time, that is called as a uniform motion. Right? So uniform motion means velocity, whatever the velocity, constant velocity, velocity is constant. Velocity constant means acceleration zero. Velocity constant means acceleration zero. Yes, all of you know this thing, na Prabhakaran. So charges are moving. Consider the charges are moving with an first case. I'm considering it as a uniform velocity. Means constant velocity, na? Charges are moving with uniform velocity. Constant velocity. Then acceleration is zero. Acceleration is zero. So now here, all of you, consider we have some conductor. Let us say in this conductor, let us say charges are moving like this. In this conductor, charges are moving like this. Now tell me, now because of this moment of the charges through this conductor, what happens? I have a conductor is like this. In this conductor, charges are flowing like this, upward direction. Consider, because of this moment of the charges through any conductor, what we have? Because of the moment of the charges through any conductor, what we have, what we'll get? What we'll get? There is a current we have now. Charge flow causes the current or not? Yes. Now see this thing here. Yes. As we know, whenever there is a flow of current through any conductor, we have a magnetic flux lines now. Whenever there is a flow of current through a conductor, we have a magnetic flux lines we have now. Yes, how the magnetic flux lines are like this manner, isn't it? The magnetic flux lines like this now. Isn't it? Because of the flow of charges, we have a current. This current will causes the magnetic flux lines and a H I'm calling. Right. Now if you see carefully here, yes, the flow of charges. The flow of charges will causes what? Flow of charges will cause us what? Flow of current. Flow of charges will cause us what? Flow of current. Whenever there is a flow of current through any conductor, what we have? We have a magnetic field, I can say now. Isn't it? We have a magnetic field around the conductor, we can say now, isn't it? Magnetic field H. Now, see this thing here. Here, how the charges are flowing here? How the charges are flowing here? Uniform flow of charges, uniform flow of charges will cause us what? Charges are flowing uniformly na? Uniform flow of charges will cause us what? Current. Yes, how that current, I'm asking. Yes, how that current? Because of the charge flow, we have a current, no doubt. How the charge are flowing uniformly, constantly we are flowing and constantly moving like this now here, then because of that we have a current. How that current, I'm asking, how that current is a how that current is a constantly, constantly. So then if you draw the waveform, let us consider If I draw a waveform, the variation of current with respect to time, let us say this is I of t. Now tell me how this plot now you will get. How this plot you will get? How this plot will get now here? Linear. How this plot will get? How the charge are flowing? Yes, how the charge are flowing here? Uniformly they are flowing like this or not? The same velocity are moving or not? Yes, because of this motion, constant motion, then how the current I am asking? How the current I am asking? Charge same means current must be same or not? Yes. Yes, Prabhakaran, yes, exactly, current is constant like this. Hana boliye. Current is constant, current we have or not? Isn't it? So then we have a constant current. Yes or no? Yes. This constant current, which we used to call it as, what we'll say it is now, DC, isn't it? So equal amplitude now here, current is constant, isn't it? Yes, isn't it? We can call that as a DC, I can say. Fine. Now tell me here. Now coming to here, look at now here. So the flow of current will cause the magnetic field, right? Now tell me what happens now. This thing, we have a current, we have, because the current we have a magnetic field. How the current here, it is a constant current. However, the magnetic field, I'm asking, how about the magnetic field now? How about the magnetic field now? How about the magnetic field now? Yes, because of the current only we'll get a magnetic field, isn't it? How the magnetic field, because the current is constant, independent of time, how about the magnetic field must be independent of time or depends upon time? Magnetic field should independent of time or dependent of time? Yes, independent of time. So since it is independent of time, we have seen now, if it is independent of anything, and we should call that as what nature? Static nature. So I can call this as what now here? Static magnetic field. Isn't it constant current? Yes. Understood what I'm saying here? We can call it static magnetic field now. So what I can say is magnetic field, it will depends upon what factors, tell me now. It depends upon what? It depends upon what? Yes, now we can take now here. Have taken this point once now. Yes, is a magnetic field from here to here, from point to point, changes or not? Magnetic field, will it changes from point to point, will changes or not? Will the magnetic field changes from point to point or not? Yes, yes or no? Amit, will it changes or not? Here, I have taken one point near to the conductor and far away from the conductor. Yes, as the distance changes, is the magnetic field changes or not? Yes, it will change or not? So means what I can say, magnetic field is depends upon time, depends upon space or independent of space? Magnetic field depends upon space or independent of space? Has to depends upon space now. So what I can say, since it is depends upon space, so we should call it as what now? X, Y, Z now. It is independent of time, as we already seen now. independent of time. We already seen this thing now here. So this magnetic field depends upon only space, independent of time. That's why we'll call it as what now? Static magnetic fields. Okay. The study of the static magnetic fields is called as a magnetostatics. The study of the static magnetic fields is called as a magnetostatics. Right. Yes. Purinjida. Right, fine. Now complete this thing now here. Next we'll say third case now. First case we have seen the charges at rest. Second case we have seen the charges are moving with what? Uniform velocity. And what's the other possible case? What's the other possible case? What's the other possible case? Yes, Deepika, what's the other possible cases now here? Charges are moving with what now? Non-uniform velocity? Yes, sir. No. Yes. Now, so up to here, copying this thing now here, just give a gap for 2 to 3 lines. Give some space for 2 to 3 lines and take the next case. Yes, and what the other case now here? Charges are moving. Charges are moving with non-uniform velocity, means I can say with some acceleration. In this case, acceleration is non-zero, with some acceleration. Okay, now tell me, look at here, what's going to happen? Listen carefully, try to understand each and everything. So yeah, these things you have to understand from the attending class only. Yes, focus on the understand the class first. Yes, listen, the answers, no, concentrate kar. Look at now here, when we have this electric field, tell me what the reason for the electric field, what the cause of the electric field? Charge, isn't it? What the cause for the electric field is a charge. If the charge varies, what happens? If the charge changes, what happens now? Electric field also has to change, isn't it? If the charge varies, means electric field also has to change, isn't it? Now see, if the charge varies, how about the current? I'm asking, if the charge changes, how about the current? How charge varies, charge changes means, is the current constant or variable current? Yes, current has to vary, yes or no? If the charge constant, then current constant. But charge, if the charge changes, means current has to change or not variable? If the current varies, then how about the magnetic field? Has to vary or not? If the current changes, magnetic field has to vary or not? So means what we can say here in this case, how the charges are moving with an acceleration means has to move with a non-uniform velocity or not. That means charges are changing now from time to time. Charge changes, that means whatever the electric field, it should depends upon what? X, Y, Z. Yes, in addition to that, time also will change, depends now. And the magnetic field, yes, how it should be now? Depends upon x, y, z space and also time, yes or no. Understood this thing? Why the t here? Why we have extra t? We have charge varies means current vary. Charge varies means electric field has to vary. Electric field changes and the current changes. The current changes means magnetic field also change with respect to time. Yes sir, no. Yes sir, no. Now in this case, what happens now here? How this electric and magnetic fields are depends upon what? How this electric and magnetic fields are depends upon what? Both space and time, isn't it? Will depends upon space as well as time also will depends now here. Yes, previously when those are independent of time, we call them as what nature? Static nature we call now. Now these are depends upon time. So what I should call them as a? What I should call them as a? Dynamic. Or I can also call this as a time varying. Dynamic fields are time varying fields. Yes, in this case when the electric and magnetic field depends upon both space and time, in this case electric field will depends upon the magnetic field. Electric field will depends upon the magnetic field and magnetic field will depends upon the electric field. Electric field depends upon magnetic field. Magnetic field depends upon electric field. That means what now? Electric and magnetic fields are interdependent. Interdependent. Yes. The study of interdependency of the electric and magnetic fields is called as a electromagnetic fields. The study of interdependency of the electric and magnetic fields is called as a electromagnetic fields. Right. Yes, got it now? Now, see this thing here. We have seen this thing here. Charge is a fundamental element. It will cause us electric fields, magnetic fields, and also electromagnetic fields. That's what we have seen now. We'll call electric field, magnetic field and electromagnetic field. That's what we have seen now. Those are three things we have seen. Isn't it? Right. Now look at here. The first case. Listen here. Answer my question. First case we have seen charge is at rest. When the charge is at rest, in this case I have discussed about only the electric field only. What about the magnetic field? I'm asking, what about the magnetic field? Do we have or not? Tell me, do we have or not? No. Why? Why? Why there is no magnetic field in this case, I'm asking. Yes, charge is at rest. When the charge is at rest, we have, yes, current is zero na. Current zero means then there is no magnetic field. Current zero, then there is no magnetic field. In this case, what we have? In this case, what we have? We have only electric fields only will exist. In this case, we have only electric fields only exist. Chalo. Next one. See here now. Now coming to in this case, when the charges are moving with uniform velocity, in this case, we have seen what we have seen. We have seen about the magnetic field. Yes or no? What about the electric field in this case? What about the electric field in this case? Do we have electric field or not in this case? I'm asking. Do the electric field will exist or not exist? When we have electric fields, when we have electric field, if the charge present, we have electric field. When we have electric field, if the charge present, we have electric field, irrespective of the state of a particle, irrespective of the state of a particle, whether the charge is rest or moving, whatever it may be, if the charge is there, we have electric field is there. ठीक है? So now अभी बोलो, in this case, do we have electric field will exist or not exist in this case? Exist or not exist in this case? When we have the electric field, if the charge is there, we have electric field. The charge may be rest, may be moving, whatever it may be. If the charge is there, we have electric field. We have. Understood? We have electric field also will exist or not exist? Will exist na? Yes or no? In this case, electric field also exists. ठीक है? Yes. So, but one thing here, in this case, both electric and magnetic field will exist, but electric and magnetic fields are independent of each other. Electric and magnetic fields are what? Independent of each other. I ask you to leave some space here na. After completion of this thing, I ask you to leave some space here. In that space, write down. In that space, Liko, write down. When the charges, write down this point. When the charges are moving with uniform velocity, when the charges are moving with uniform velocity, both electric and magnetic fields will exist. Both electric and magnetic fields will exist. Both electric and magnetic fields will exist. But the electric and magnetic fields are, but the electric and magnetic fields are independent of each other. But the electric and magnetic fields are independent of each other. Yes, over. Yes, understood this point. When the charges are moving with uniform velocity, both will exist. Electric and magnetic field will exist, but the electric and magnetic fields are independent of each other. Independent of each other. Come into this case now here. Tell me, what about this case now here? Charges are moving with acceleration. In that case, what we have? Electric field is there, magnetic field is also there. Electric field is there, magnetic field also there. And both will exist, and both depends upon what now? Space and time. In this case, electric field depends upon magnetic field. Magnetic field depends upon electric field. There is a relation between the electric and magnetic field are related like this. Electric and magnetic fields are depends upon one other. That's why these are called as electromagnetic fields. Electromagnetic fields. Now, if you see carefully, in this case, how the current is a constant current now in this case. And can I call this is nothing but DC? Can I call this is a DC? Can I call this a DC or not? Yes, current is constant. Now come into here, in this case, what I should call this is now here, current is changing or not? I can call this as AC, I can say. I can call it AC, I can say. Isn't it? Now if you see carefully, in case of a DC, that means when the charge is moving with uniform velocity, in case of DC, how the electric and magnetic fields are? How the electric and magnetic fields are? How the electric and magnetic fields in case of DC depends on one another or independent? How the electric and magnetic field, Prabhakaran, how the electric and magnetic field in this case depends on independent? Independent, isn't it? Now tell me here, in case of AC, how the electric and magnetic fields are? In case of AC, how the electric and magnetic fields are? Dependent, isn't it? How the electric and magnetic fields are? Dependent. Yes. Now, why the electric and magnetic fields are independent in case of a DC? Why the electric and magnetic fields are dependent in case of AC? Why the electric and magnetic fields are dependent in case of AC? Why it is independent in case of a DC? That what we are going to study in our subject. That what we are going to study in our subject. Why the electric and magnetic fields are independent in case of a DC case. DC case, and why these are dependent in case of AC case. If it is depends upon one other, what are the consequences will takes place? What are things will happens? And those things we are going to learn in our subject. That is the electromagnetic field study. What is the dependency? How the dependency? What if it is depends upon one other? What are the things we can use? What are applications? If it is depends on the applications, we are going to learn in our subject. Right. The dependency of the electric field on magnetic field, this phenomena was first explained by the Faraday. The dependency of the electric field on magnetic field, it was explained by the Faraday. Right? Fine. Understood now up to here? Up to here? Yes, Deepika has given one doubt. Let me see this thing. In case of a case 2, why we only consider H? Yeah, see this thing here. Deepika understood what I'm saying. In addition to the electric field, magnetic field is also there. Electric field is there, magnetic field is also there. But here, that's what I'm saying, both electric field is also there. Now you try to understand here the scenario here. Fine, charge. Whatever the electric field, if we have a charge now here, let us consider, observe this thing here. Let us say here, A, B, C. I have taken 3 points. Assume that. Let us say here, at this point, I am observing here. This is my observation point. This is my observation point. You can see here. Now, what I am saying is, here, this distance and this distance is same. Same distances. When the charges are with uniform velocity, what happens, tell me? Uniform velocity means, I have one charge here. Yes, here also we have one charge. Here also we have one charge. Consider. When the charge moving from this point to this one, let us consider. Charge moving from this point to this point, from A to B, and some other charge will come to the point A. Yes, sir. No, since your constant velocity and moving the same velocity, all the charges move with the same velocity. So when one charge is shifting from A to B, some other charge will come to point B, will come now here. Then at any instant of time, you will find some charge and that to equal charge at the point A. Yes, sir. No. Now, I want to find the electric field at this point now here. I want to find the electric field at this point. Tell me, what is the electric field now here? What is the electric field now here? So will be always, so here, when the charge is here, again we have charge is there now, that because of this charge we have electric field constant value we have now. Isn't it understood what I am saying here? Here if you see carefully, the charges are seems to be stationary. Charges are seems to be stationary, but actually they are moving. Yes, sir, no. Charges are, it will look, it will seem to be like a stationary, but they are moving uniformly, they are moving now. Isn't it? That's a scenario. Okay. Right. Fine. There are the things we have seen now. Right. Now coming to this thing here, yes, the basic analogy here, and yes, as we know, every time we need to satisfy the fundamental laws. Yes, the entire universe will depend upon the one fundamental principle of universe. What is the basic fundamental law of universe? What is the law of universe is what? What is the law of universe? Law of conservation of energy. Yes, sir. No, the entire universe will depend upon this principle. Now, law of conservation of energy. Yes, sir. No, energy. Yes, this is the basic law of universe, isn't it? Yes, and what is the law of conservation of energy is, energy can neither be created nor destroyed, but we can transform from one form to another form, but we can transform to one form to another form. Yes, so as we know, according to the Einstein theory, energy has a dual nature. Yes, sir, no. Energy is available in a dual nature now. Yes, the energy which is in the form of what we can say, it is a particle in nature as well as a wave nature. Isn't it? Energy which is available in a dual form now here, particle in nature as well as a wave nature, I can say. According to Einstein theory, Yes or no? We used to say energy will be available in the form of packets, which we used to call it as a quanta. Energy is available in the form of a packets, which we used to call it as a quanta. We used to say or not? And energy will propagate from one point to another point in the form of a waves. Energy will propagate from one point to another point in the form of a waves. Right. Now see this thing. Particle. If we consider particles. Yes. Some particles you can see will have a mass. Some particles will have a mass, isn't it? And some other particles will have a charge. Some particles will have a mass, some other particles will have a charge, isn't it? Right. Let us consider this massed particle. Let us say this massed particle. And this massed particle, let us say this is at rest. And let us say massed particle which is moving. When a massed particle is at rest, it will have some energy. When a massed particle is moving, also it has some energy. Yes sir, no. When a massed particle is at rest, it has energy. When it is moving also, it has energy now. Let us see now this particle. This is a massed particle. This is at rest. Tell me, what is the energy possessed by this particle when it is at rest? Energy possessed by this particle when it is at rest. What is the energy of this particle is? The energy because of its own weight, I can say. Yes or no? The energy possessed by this particle is because of its own weight na here. What we used to call the type of energy? What we used to call the type of energy? Tell me. What we'll call the type of energy? Huh? What we'll call the type of energy here? Isn't it? What we'll call the type of energy? Prabhakaran. What we'll call the type of energy is a? Potential energy. Rashtma, that is potential energy, isn't it? And when the particle is moving, then what energy it has? When the particle is moving, what is the energy it has? What is this energy? We'll call that as a kinetic energy. Yes or no? Yes. Now, this massed particle, we have two energies. When it is at rest, that energy we have defined. Who given this potential kinetic energy? We defined ourselves for the analysis of a massed particle. We have defined. When it is at rest, that energy we call it as a potential energy. When it is moving, that energy we call it as a kinetic energy. Exactly. Yes or no? Exactly similar analysis we are going to make here also. Consider. Yes, this charged particle. The charged particle which is also may be at rest. And the charged particle may be moving now. Now tell me. What is the energy possessed by the charged particle when it is at rest and when it is moving? Yes, the energy possessed by the particle when it is at rest, that energy is called as a electric field. That energy is called as what? Electric field. When it is moving, that energy is called as a magnetic field. When it is moving, that energy is called as a magnetic field. Now tell me here. Now tell me, when the charged particle is at rest, that energy is called as a electric field. When it is moving, that energy we called as a magnetic, isn't it? Now, so now here, for the analysis of a charged particle also, we have defined when it is at rest, that energy we call electric field. When it is moving, that energy we call as a magnetic field. Now, tell me, look at now this massed particle here. Look at the massed particle once, all of you here. When the massed particle is at rest, what the energy, tell me? When the massed particle is at rest, what energy? When the massed particle is at rest, what energy? Only P. Can I say only PE? Haan na boliye. Can I say only PE? Yes or no? Next, when the charged particle is at rest, when the charged particle is at rest, what is the energy? When the charged particle is at rest, what is the energy? Yes, electric field. Only electric field or charged particle? When the charged particle is at rest, what is the energy? What is the energy now? Electric field? Can I say only electric field? Can I say only electric field? Yes or no? Can I say only electric field? Right. Now, so see this thing here. When the charged particle is at rest, it is only potential energy. When the massed particle is at rest, only potential energy. When the charged particle is at rest, only electric field. Isn't it? Now tell me, when the charged particle is moving, what is the energy? Tell me, when the massed particle is moving, what is the energy? When the massed particle is moving, what is the energy? What is the energy? Yes, what is the energy? Is it only kinetic energy? Is it only kinetic energy? It is a combination of kinetic and potential energy also. It's a combination of kinetic energy and potential energy also, isn't it? Now, when the charged particle is moving, what is the energy? When the charged particle is moving, what is energy? It's a combination of what? Electric field and magnetic field. Isn't it? Understood what I'm saying here? When the charged particle is at rest, electric field. When the charged particle is moving, it is a combination of both electric field and magnetic field. Yes or no? Yes. So from this, what we can say here now, here the properties of this electric field I can compare with the potential energy. I can correlate with the potential energy, and I can correlate the magnetic field with the kinetic energy. We can correlate or not? Isn't it? That's a beauty of the electromagnetics. Yes, how we have a two energies for this massed particle? Exactly, we have a, yes, the two energies for the charged particle also. Yes. Prabhakaran. Yes. Got it. What I'm saying. Yes. Understood now here. Feel aya. Aapko. Yes. Right. That's about this thing. We have seen the nature of the particle nature. right. Coming to this wave nature, let us talk about this wave nature. And of course, there are the different type of waves we have. And here, mostly we'll talk about the two types of waves we'll talk here. We'll discuss here. There are so many types of waves. We'll talk about the major two wave types of waves. And one is electromagnetic waves. Energy will propagate in the form of a different type of waves, different situations. Mechanical waves, vibrational waves, we used to say, but we'll talk about only the two waves now. One is electromagnetic waves. The other one is VI waves. One is electromagnetic waves. The other one is VI waves. Electromagnetic waves. What are they meant by VI waves? What is meant by VI waves? Voltage and current waves. VI waves means what? Voltage and current waves. The energy will propagate in the form of voltage and current. Those are called as a VI waves. And the electromagnetic waves. Can you give me any example for electromagnetic waves? Any example for electromagnetic waves? Any example for electromagnetic waves? Yes, microwaves, example I'm asking, practical example I'm asking. Light, simply, light is electromagnetic wave, isn't it? Light is electromagnetic wave, The mobile communications is electromagnetic wave. Yes or no? Mobile communication light is a best example of electromagnetic wave, Yes. Now you can just imagine how we are getting a sunlight from sun to earth. What the medium between us, sun to earth? What the medium is? Air, free space, vacuum, I can say, isn't it? So now do we have, yes, here is the sun and here we have vacuum. Yes, earth we have, let us consider here. And do we have any physical connection between these two, sun to earth? Do we have any physical connection? We do have any physical conductors from these two? There is no physical connection. Still there is a flow of energy will be taken place from sun to earth or not? Still there is energy will be takes place from sun to earth, isn't it? So what we can say now here, even though there is no physical connection from sun to earth, we are getting a sunlight, we are getting or not? Yes. Now what is the conductivity of a free space vacuum? How much sigma conductivity? Sigma, which is defined only for the conductors only, How much the sigma of a free space? Do we have any physical conductor from sun to earth? We don't have any physical connection. Without any physical connection, we are getting the sunlight, we are getting or not? How much the sigma of the electromagnet for the propagation of electromagnetic waves? Zero, I can say sigma of the for the propagation of electromagnetic waves, conductivity zero. Yes or no? All of you following properly, right? Next, VI waves means voltage and current waves, Yes, tell me, for the propagation of voltage and current waves, yes, do we have sigma is required or not required? Sigma required or not? In a household, the energy will propagate in the form of a voltage and current waves, Sigma required or not? How much sigma will be required now? As high as possible. Ideally speaking, sigma, I can say it should be very high. I can say it tends to infinity, I can say now. sigma must be very high, I can say, should tends to infinity, I can say, isn't it? And how much the frequency of our household supplies? How much the frequency of a household supply? Yeah, some of the frequency we use now, that is the 50 hertz frequency, na? Isn't it? 50 hertz frequency. Next. How much the frequency of the electromagnetic waves? The frequency of the electromagnetic waves is what it is, which is very high frequency. Which is very high frequency, isn't it? Microwave frequency na, very high frequency, isn't it? Now just look at here, just compare Prabhakaran, yes, following, just compare this thing, the two scenarios now here, electromagnetic waves and VI waves, compare this thing. For the propagation of the electromagnetic waves, how much the sigma? How much the sigma for the electromagnetic waves propagation? Sigma is 0. For the propagation of the VI waves, how much the sigma value should be high, very high. And the electromagnetic waves are high frequency signals. Whereas VI waves are what? Low frequency waves. Na? Electromagnetic waves are high frequency waves and VI waves are very low frequency waves now, isn't it? The completely different operations, isn't it? Electromagnetic waves and VI waves. And this VI waves topics, and we'll discuss that is separate subject. Which subject the VI waves discussion? Which subject the discussion of VI waves? Where we'll discuss the VI waves? Networks, we will discuss the VI waves. Networks is VI waves only now, voltage and current only we'll discuss, isn't it? The C frequency, 0 frequency and 50 hertz frequency only we'll talk now, isn't it? That is a other subject, that is a networks. And here the electromagnetic waves will focus, yes. That's why, you know, I'm very good in these subjects, networks and EMT, yes or no? Yes, this the flow diagram only we are discussing now, right? Now coming to here, yes, simple example here, the mobile communication. Yes, you can see mobile now by simply dialing, by simply dialing some random numbers in your mobile, you can able to communicate with your friends or not. And do you have any physical connection to the two mobiles? Do you have any physical connection between the one mobile to other mobile? Without any physical connection, you can able to communicate with your friends, far away friends also now. Still, there is no connection. If we landlines, you can see we have a connection is there, but here mobiles we don't have any physical connection, and still there is a flow of energy will be taken place even though there is no excuse me physical connection, isn't it? Right, that's the beauty of these electromagnetic waves. Just imagine. Let us say that electromagnetic waves will propagate only through a conductor. Let us say electromagnetic waves will propagate only through a conductor. Just imagine what will happen. Consider, just imagine the situation. Electromagnetic waves will propagate only through a conductor. Consider then scenario. How the scenario will changes? Will you get a sunlight? If the electromagnetic waves will propagate only through a conductor only, will get a sunlight, sun and earth. Yes, for the to get a sunlight, what should be now? There should be connection, must be there now. Wire conducting media must be there or not? Will you get a sunlight from sun to earth? There is no physical connection now. We don't get any sunlight. Understood what I'm saying here? We don't get any sunlight. Will you use our mobile phones? Tell me now. Will you use our mobile phones? Is a mobile phone will work? We can't. Now you just imagine. Yes, how we are addicted to our mobile phones. We can live nowadays, we can live without khana peena, but without mobile, impossible na? Isn't it? Isn't it? We can live without food also, khana peena. Yes, but without mobile, very difficult na, impossible scenario, isn't it? Yes, see the scenario here now. So from this, what we can say now here, we can write one statement here. So from this, what we can say now, VI waves, what I can say VI waves now here, VI waves are low frequency waves, VI waves are low frequency waves, and those can propagate through where? Only conductors. So write down the statement, write down one point, write down, VI waves are low frequency waves, and those can propagate only through the conductors. Only through the conductors. Next slide. Electromagnetic waves are high frequency waves. Electromagnetic waves are high frequency waves, and those can propagate only through the sigma zero means dielectric. Electromagnetic waves are high frequency waves, and those can propagate only through the dielectrics. Lika? Electromagnetic waves are high frequency waves, and those can propagate only through the dielectrics. Over now. All of you. Yes, Prabhakaran, got it? Yes, Likada? Right. Next. Fine, let us consider here. I have my mobile. Yes, I have mobile here. Let us consider mobile. In our mobile, I want to enjoy the FM signal. FM radio is electromagnetic waves now. FM radio is electromagnetic waves. And can you give me any FM frequency now here? We used to say. So 92.5 something. Yeah, 93.5. Okay. This thing, FM signal frequency 92.7, like this. Now 93.5, after that what is that? Mega. This is the carrier frequency. I think all of you know about this thing, 93.5, that is a carrier frequency, isn't it? Yes, this much. Now you tell me now, megahertz frequency now here, this FM signal is a electromagnetic wave. Let us say that I want to enjoy the FM signal in our in my mobile. Kya hua? What happened? Ek bar abhi refresh karo. 1 minute. Yes, Deepika, is it okay now? See here, let us consider here. I want F. Yes. Now let us say here, I want to enjoy the FM signal in my mobile. So what I should do, when your trail switch on FM radio in your mobile, what happens now? What happens now when you switch on FM radio in your mobile, you will get one small display. What's the display you will see? You'll get one small display. You can see now when you are trying to switch on FM radio in your mobile, you get one small display. Now what a display you will get, tell me. What's the display you'll get? What is the display I'm asking? Connect headset. Yes or no? You'll get one small display. What is the display you'll get now? Connect headset. Yes or no? Why that headset? Why that headset? Yes. The headset will contains what now here, inbuilt antenna, isn't it? Headset will contain some inbuilt antenna will contains or not? Yes, FM signal is a electromagnetic wave. FM signal is a electromagnetic wave. Your mobile is a electrical device. Mobile is a electrical device. Your mobile can detect only the VI waves only. Will detect only VI waves only. It cannot detect the electromagnetic waves directly. So what we need to do? We need to convert this F electromagnetic waves to VI waves. For that purpose, we require one conversion device. That is, we require one transducer. We require one transducer. Yes. The transducer is named as what? Antenna. We require one transducer. The transducer is named as antenna. Antenna will convert the electromagnetic waves to VI waves and vice versa. Vice versa. We require one transducer. This transducer will convert electromagnetic waves to VI waves and vice versa. Isn't it? Right. Yes. Fine. You may ask one doubt. Yes, mobile communication is also electromagnetic wave only, na? Mobile communication is also electromagnetic waves only, na? Yes, even though without any headset, how we can able to listen the scenario? Tell me. Mobile communication is also electromagnetic waves only, na? Yes, now tell me. So without any antenna, that means headset, you can able to talk or not? You can able to listen, na? Why? I am asking. Tell me. Yes. Is a mobile will contains antenna? Is a mobile contain antenna or not? Yes, mobile will contain antenna. Every mobile will have an antenna, that is a microstrip antenna. But that working the range of frequencies for that microstrip antenna is a frequency, very high frequency will work, isn't it? So in the order of gigahertz frequency. Mobile communication will be in the order of gigahertz. That antenna will be designed to work for the high frequencies, very high frequencies. And here this but FM signal is a low frequency now. So to accept this thing here, we require one more antenna required. This range of frequencies, one other device is required. That's why we require the headset is required. What the major purpose of this mobile phone, tell me? For the FM signal or mobile communication? FM signal, mobile communication. Mobile communication now. So that antenna, yes, the inbuilt antenna is designed to work for the mobile communications only. As we know, you might heard in analog circuits, gain and bandwidth product is always constant. Gain and bandwidth, the product now, the gain and bandwidth is always constant now. So if you want the high bandwidth, gain has to decrease. Is it Prabhakaran? Understood what I am saying? If we require the high bandwidth, means we require the gain has to compromise, isn't it? So that's the reason. So here, in addition to this inbuilt antenna, we require one more additional antenna is required. That antenna will take care of the FM communications. Okay. Chalo, understood now? Isn't it? All of you understood these topics? Right. Yes. Prabhakaran, got it? Right. Prabhakaran, Purinjina. Right. Chalo. Yes. That's the thing we are going to discuss. Coming to our syllabus. What the flow diagrams we have seen, that is our syllabus. The flow chart we have seen, that is our syllabus. Yes. And you have already studied this about the potential energy and kinetic energy in your plus 2. Yes, we don't discuss about the potential energy and kinetic energy here. Right. Now here, we'll discuss about this electric field, magnetic fields. Right. Electromagnetic waves. VI waves means transmission lines. And the antennas we'll discuss. Right. Coming to our syllabus, if it's right. Right. So we have divided complete our syllabus into some chapters we have divided. The first chapter. First chapter will discuss about the static electric fields. Static electric fields. Yes. Second chapter will discuss about the static magnetic fields. Second chapter, static magnetic fields. And the third chapter is electromagnetic fields. Third chapter is electromagnetic fields, we'll discuss. Yes. Deepika, what happened? Yeah, yes, fine. I will provide. I will provide. Don't worry. I will provide the electromagnetic waves. When you are discussing, they will concentrate. We'll discuss those topics. We'll discuss. Right. Now, this is the first chapter, first unit we are just calling here. And the first unit here, you all are, yes, is there any electricals are there? Electrical, you are all are, you see, yeah, electrical, any electricals? Any electrical? Yes, Prabhakaran, are you electric? You see, yeah, electrical? Yes, Deepak is not attended now. So, here, so this is the syllabus for electrical guys. This is the syllabus for electrical, up to here only. This is the syllabus for electrical guys. This is the syllabus. And for electronics, in addition to this, some other chapters also there. Yes, and these three chapters are fundamentals for the electronics. Why? Because in this one here, we need to study, we need to do the research in about the four important equations. Those are called as what? Maxwell's equations. Those are called as a Maxwell's equations. Yes, in the three chapters we'll understand the Maxwell's equation. What is when Maxwell's equation? What is the significance of this Maxwell's equation? Why we use this Maxwell's equations? We do the research in the Maxwell's equations. Right. Yes, in addition to this, you copy the syllabus. In addition to this, the second chapter, I can say this is continuation, that is the electromagnetic waves. I can say the second chapter is what? Electromagnetic waves. And here in the first three chapters, we'll derive the Maxwell's equations. And based upon this Maxwell's equation, we have to analyze the propagation of the electromagnetic waves. We have seen previously, what we have seen now, the electromagnetic waves, where the electromagnetic waves will propagate? Where the electromagnetic waves will propagate? Only dielectrics na sigma zero na? Electromagnetic waves will propagate only through dielectrics only. Electromagnetic waves cannot propagate through the conductors. Electromagnetic waves does not propagate through the conductor. We'll see why the electromagnetic waves does not propagate through the conductors. Why the electromagnetic waves will only propagate through the dielectrics only. What happened to when an electromagnetic wave is incidenting on the conductor surface, where that energy was gone? We need to analyze all the phenomena in this electromagnetic wave chapters. By using the four Maxwell's equations, we derived in the first chapter. Okay. Next. After that, we are going to see the High frequency VA waves. We have two types of VA waves. One is a low frequency VA waves, high frequency VA waves. Low frequency VA waves means frequency is 50 Hz. That is a networks. High frequency VA waves means we are going to discuss this. We can also call it as a transmission lines. This we can also call it as what? Transmission lines. Right. The next one, the another chapter. Next we'll discuss about the, yes, waveguides. Waveguides we'll discuss. Next, we'll discuss about the the radiation mechanism, antennas. Antennas we are going to discuss. This is our complete syllabus. This is our complete syllabus. ठीक है, कॉपी ना दिस थिंग, कितने शेड्यूल है. ओके, सो राइट नाउ आई एम प्लानिंग दिस शेड्यूल इज अप टू फेब्रवरी 9th, आई थिंक सो फेब्रवरी 9th आई थिंक आई प्लान्ड. ओके, फेब्रवरी 9th आई थिंक सो, यस यस. आफ्टर दैट ओके, सो इट्स अ पार्ट वन. नेक्स्ट आफ्टर दैट पार्ट टू पार्ट थ्री लाइक दिस विल डू. I think it will take the March ending tak will chalega. March ending it will take the March ending, I think so. Right, got it na, up to here fine. This is the scenario here. I think with this brief, with this introduction, this complete thing we have did a just introduction to our subject. With this introduction, I think all of you might have some idea about our subject. What we are going to study in our subject. Isn't it? What we are going to study in our subject. Clear now these concepts? Yes, as I told here, I will think that you don't know anything from the zero onwards, will keep on, will move. Yes, got this thing now here completely. Hope you enjoyed the up to here fine. So the same manner will continue our complete syllabus. The same manner will discuss our complete syllabus. Theek hai, chalo. Now let us see some basic definition for our subject. Take down. Yes, the basic terms I can say. Basic terms, take them one by one. First one, electric field intensity. Electric field intensity. Take down the definition. Write down. It is the measure of the strength of the electric field at a given point. Strength of the electric field at a given point. Next line, write down. The force experienced by a test charge yes, Electric field intensity means what it is now? It is a measure of the strength of the electric field at a given point. How much the electric field at a given point, that was indicated by the electric field intensity. Right? Means, for example, if we have a charge here, let us say I have some charge Q here. Because of the charge Q at this location, we have some effect of the charge at this location or not? Yes. So the effect of the charge at this location is called as electric field. I want to measure how much the electric field at that location, how much the strength of the this charge at this location, that is called as electric field intensity. The strength of the electric field at electric at the particular point. For this purpose, what we'll do is, at this location I'm placing a one test charge QT. What the QT is? A test charge. Yes. So then if when you play the charge QT here, this charge will repel this QT with certain force, na? This charge will repel this QT with certain force, will repel or not? Let us say positive charge. With how much force this Q will repel this QT, that force is called as a electric field. That force is called as a electric field. So from this, what we can define of this electric field intensity? Electric field intensity E, which is given as what I can say, limit QT tends to 0, that is F by QT. Limit QT tends to 0, F by QT is called as a electric field intensity. Understood this thing? What are the QT here? Test charge QT. Here QT test charge QT have taken up 0. Why QT should tends to 0? Why the QT should tends to 0? Is it, if it is not tends to 0, what happens? It's a very important. See here. What is this thing? What is this E is the electric field caused by which charge? Electric field caused by this charge, now, isn't it? I want the electric field caused by this charge alone. For that purpose, this other charge should not offer any electric field, I can say. Yes or no? For that, the other charge should not offer any electric field. Yes or no? Yes. Now here, if this QT also offering some electric field, let us say, if the QT is also offering some electric field, then we'll call that as a net field, I can say, now. Try to understand. Here, this E means, what the E is, the electric field caused by the charge alone. I want to get the effect of the charge alone. For that purpose, the charge should not offer any electric field or not. When the QT does not offer any electric field, provided that QT 0, yes or no? If QT is non-zero, then we'll call net field, I can say, now, isn't it? So that's why QT must be 0 here. Understood? Yes. Now what's the units now here? What's the units now? Newtons per coulombs now. Force per charge. Newtons per coulombs. The other unit. What the other unit we have? It is a volts per meter also. The another unit is what? Volts per meter. The electric field intensity. Another unit is volts per meter. We use mostly volts per meter, we use for unit of electric field intensity. Mostly we use volts per meter. Right. Next one. the next definition. But sir, according to formula QT equal to E will be, see this thing here. Yes, QT 0, it is infinity. See this thing here. Limit x tends to 0. Then, what is this thing here as a 2? How much this value? Tell me. Understood, what's going to happen? Yes, sir, no. Understood here, yeah. This thing, isn't it? Deepika, yes, koi doubt hai isme? Yes, Amit, got it now this thing? Good question, yes, right. Yes, like this. If you have any doubt, ask me so that we'll clear the doubts. We'll rectify all our doubts. Right. Next one. Electric flux density. The electric flux density D. Tell me electric flux density D, which is given as, take the definition. The amount of flux. Crossing through the given surface area. The amount of flux crossing through the given surface area. Yes, the electric flux density D, which is given as, this is given as, we can write it as electric flux per surface area. Electric flux per surface area. Yes, which is given as what we can say. This is, we can say it is d psi by ds into en cap. Well, d psi is a differential electric flux through the differential surface area. D psi means small electric flux through the small surface area. En cap. En cap is a unit vector normal to the given surface. En cap is a unit vector normal to the given surface. So for example, let us say here, we should call the electric flux lines. Let us say electric flux lines are like this. Consider we have some surfaces like this. Yes, if I place some surface now here, yes, I have taken a small part in the surface. Yes, through this small part, some flux lines will cross on D psi. And this small area I am calling as ds. There is an angle between these two is something theta. Yes. Now, so we can call the electric flux density D, which is defined as what? It is a d psi by ds. And the direction was given by what? En cap. En cap is a unit vector, will give us the direction of the electric flux density. En cap is called as a unit normal vector. Unit normal vector. will give the directions of the flux density, will give us. Right. And this units are given as what now here? Coulombs per meter square. Flux, electric flux units are coulombs. So coulombs per meter square. So from this we can get the flux now here. From this we'll get the flux, which is given as what I can say, surface integral of d dot ds. Surface integral of d dot ds. Then the units will become coulombs. Units will become coulombs. Right. This is my electric flux. Right. So if the D is a constant, I can write this thing as what we can say here. D integral of ds, I can say area into cos theta, I can write now, isn't it? Flux is equal to D. D is an electric flux density. What E is a area, and theta, what theta is a, yes, theta is angle between what to what here, D and A. Angle between here dot product na, A dot B is equal to mod A mod B into cos of angle between them, isn't it? So theta is the angle between D and DS.